Shalom, shalom. Welcome to another beautiful program.
Shalom.
We got our good elder, Elder Benya.
Praise the mighty Yah.
With the message from our elder from the house of Israel, here to bring us another great message. What's going on, Elder Benya?
Hey, hallelujah. And so we always say, I know it's been a while, but we're back and the Holy Creator loves you and so do we.
Praise the mighty Yah. Hallelujah.
Praise the mighty Yah.
So what's going on out there, Elder? Let us know what's happening.
Oh, man, there's so much going on, so much, so little time, and we're way behind, I know, but I couldn't be helped. But I do, I think I want to start off with, I've been hearing some things about our young black men and black women, you know, and the things that they're doing out there. You know, we've got... this country has allowed a lot of different other countries, you know, that's come in, and they made their home. A lot of them are trying to make their home here and stuff and all, and it's just a big breeding ground here now. And like they've with a young man, from what I understand, is that they are now dating a lot of these are foreigners, and at the exclusion of their own ladies, and some of the girls are doing it too. And I just wanted to say something about that. You know, you don't know that you're messing up, because they're doing that on purpose. They're allowing a lot of these folks to come in this country, and all just to kind of drown you out. If you know what I speak. And you're falling right for it. Now we still got some beautiful black women, handsome black men that are waiting for that righteous person to come to them. And I'm talking about their own, your own. You folks are Hebrew Israelites, and don't forget that. Whether you know it or not, you are. The Holy Scripture talks about that. The Old Testament, and only the Old Testament. That book belongs to our people. And they all know that. Pastors and preachers and stuff, all of them know it. They've been trying to hide it. They've been hiding it for years, since we've been here in this country. But the book belongs to us, and we can prove it. I've been, you still got, you guys heard me talk about Hank and everything, and he's still at it along with some other Europeans and stuff and everything. And they're just trying to, every chance they get, trying to make it seem like the book talks about them in there, and it doesn't. But anyway, getting back to our young men and black women, and I want you guys to think loud, hard, and clear about what you're doing. And the decisions that you're making, because, you know, you're getting with these folks, these foreigners and stuff, and you're marrying them, you're having kids. But Yah has this way of turning things around on you, and it may not be too good. Moesha, what is that? That book and that chapter where it talks about, I think it's chapters 10 and... No, I asked you the other day about it and stuff and everything, and what Yah says about I forget how that goes. They had these women, these men, and they were bringing the women into, and ready to bring them into the country and stuff and everything. But Yah did not go along with it, and like he told them to turn these foreign women and their children around. And yeah, and they had to get rid of them. In other words, turn them around and make them go another way.
Yeah, but that's in the book of Ezra. We got that in Ezra, the 10th chapter.
Uh-huh. Ezra, right. I think chapter 10, yeah. Filling of what we're talking about here.
And that's Ezra chapter 10, starting at verse 1. Now, Ezra had prayed, and when he had confessed weeping, he and casting himself down before the house of Elohim. There he assembled to him out of Israel a very great congregation of men and women, and the children for the people wept very bitterly. And Shechaniah, the son of Yediel, one of the sons of Elam, answered and said to Ezra, "We have trespassed against our Elohim, and we have taken strange wives of the people of the land. Yet now there is hope in Israel concerning this thing. Now therefore, let us make a covenant with our Elohim to put away all the wives, and such are as born of them, according to the counsel of my master, and of those that tremble at the commandment of our Elohim." "And let it be done according to the law. Arise, for this matter belongs to you. We also will be with you. Be of good courage and do it." Then arose Ezra and made the chief priests, the Levites, and all Israel to swear that they should do according to this word. And they swore. And Ezra rose up from before the house of Elohim and went into the chamber of Yohanan, the son of Eliashib. And when he came there, he didn't eat no bread nor drink any water, for he mourned because of the transgression of them that had been carried away. And they made a proclamation throughout Yehuda and Jerusalem and all the children of the captivity that they should gather themselves together to Jerusalem, and that whoever would not come within 3 days according to the counsel of the princes and the elders, all that his substance should be forfeited and himself separated from the congregation of those that had been carried away. Then all the men of Yehuda and Benjamin gathered themselves together to Jerusalem within 3 days. It was the ninth month on the 20th day of the month, and all the people sat in the street of the house of Elohim trembling because of this matter and for the great rain. And Ezra the priest stood up unto them and said, "You have transgressed and have taken strange wives to increase the trespass of Israel. Now therefore make confession unto Yahweh your Elohim and your fathers and do his pleasure and separate yourselves from the people of the land and from the strange wives." Praise Almighty Yah.
There it is. I hope you heard that loud and clear. We might have to have it read again another time. We got to keep moving, but that is very serious. And we're talking about the Holy Creator here. He's did it before and he can do it again. It has happened. So don't think you can say, "Oh, what is he talking about? No, we're gonna continue doing what we want." And that's exactly what our people used to say with their hard head itself. But I'm telling you now, if you plan on making it to the kingdom, if you're following the laws, especially the commandments, that's another thing that we're going to be getting on. I mean, very heavy. I want you young folks to know that. The commandments. And there's nothing like it. Because that's what got us in a jam over 500-600 years ago, and it's still happening today. Nobody wants to keep the commandments. And it's messing us up, left and right. And we'll go into that again. But anyway, I want to speak on a group out here now. They really think they're riding up real high on the high winds. But they don't know that they're about to be destroyed if they don't watch it. And I'm speaking of Black Lives Matter. Black Lives Matter, I understand that I've been hearing some talk and that you have moved away from how you got started, because there's other groups that are within your group and they have widened your coattail. You all understand that you're all so involved and you became political. Oh, bad mistake. First of all, I hate that you started off the way you did, because we have in Isaiah chapter 30. Isaiah, you want to read that to Black Lives Matter first before I even go further, and let them know what Yah says that about doing things, but not at his
Isaiah chapter 30. Okay. Chapter. Let me get here. Isaiah, the 30th chapter, verse 1. Woe to the rebellious children, saith Yahweh, that takes counsel, but not of me. They cover with a covering, but not of my spirit, that they may add sin to sin. That walk to go down into Egypt, and have not asked in my mouth, to strengthen themselves in the strength of Pharaoh, and to trust in the shadow of Egypt. Therefore shall the strength of Pharaoh be your shame.
There.
And trust there. In the shadow of Egypt your confusion.
And the reason why I had him read that, just so that you wouldn't think that I was picking on you, is right there in the Holy Scripture. And you're not the first group that has did it. If you've listened to any of my broadcasts, and I'm hoping that you will and continue to do so, Black Lives Matter, so that you can learn something, because right now you have a an idiot that we call Tomato Face that had been doing some things back when he was president. And those things he was doing, and he had everything, that he knew what was going on with these no good for nothing, wicked cops that were going around killing off young black men and women out there in the streets. I mean murder. And he never said nothing about it, except for if the cops are looking for a friend, they got me. Well, we already knew where you were coming from in the first place, Mr. Tomato Face. But but this is to you, Black Lives Matter. He's after you now, because you seem to have made a big name for yourself. You're political now. I understand that you got a net worth of 90 million or more, and that's, you don't know just how much trouble you're in. And I know that you got some heavy hitters behind you and stuff. You got these pastors like, Sharpton and Jesse Jackson and them. They're backing you and all. You also got the backing of a LGBT. That's one of the groups that are riding off your coattail. And, you know, it's one thing about it. If I was going to start something for my people, I would not pull in other groups, especially groups that the Holy Creator is against. And the LGBT, you know, I have to say this. We don't hate you, but we hate what you're doing. What you're doing is not right, and it's against Yah's laws, and you find those laws in Leviticus chapters 20. Maury, if you would go there real quick, read chapter 20 as to a man that is found lying with another man, what happens?
He shall be put to death. That's in Leviticus, the 20th chapter, the 13th verse. If also a man also lies with mankind as he lies with a woman, both of them have committed an abomination. They shall be put to death. Their blood shall be upon them. Hallelujah.
Now you see, this is something that has never been said to you. Roman Catholic Church just seemed to go around telling folks that, you know, you all, you know, God loves everybody, and he does, but there are things that you're doing that he's against, and it's an abomination. Just like it's an abomination for the Roman Catholic Church to keep lying about it. And the rest of them. And all these other groups. But anyway, we have our own group. We have our own problem. Just like the Native Indians in this country once said. They don't want to be a part of no other groups here and there. I don't blame them. They say their plight is theirs and they're doing their own thing. And that's the way it should be. And that's the way it should be with the black man and the black woman. We don't need nobody else to come in on our plights, because you don't belong in there. Especially LGBT and a few others. You're on your own. Let's get that straight. And now back to Black Lives Matter. If you pay attention to what Donald Trump has been saying, and he even made the statement saying something about that when you guys were they made, I know it was a false statement saying that you started, you guys were at a march or something and everything, and then you started trouble, but we know that that didn't happen. It was people there who infiltrated your group. And that's another thing that you need to watch, because those people are Donald Trump's people. And they're coming in there and they're doing all kind of crazy stuff. You know, you're marching and stuff, and they'll take a brick or something, throw it at a cop, and now you guys are going to get hit. And Donald Trump already told him, he says, if when he gets back in, he's going to have, helicopters swooping down with state troopers and stuff jumping out of them with rifles with the bayonets on them. I'm pretty sure some of you heard that. He said, and he said, if you, and you just shoot him. He said, if you don't, he said, just shoot him in the leg. He wants you dead. He wants them to put an end to our people. That's what this clown is about. That's why, and let me tell you something. And he's got he's got more people backing him now more than ever. That's what's scary about this whole thing. And if he don't get back in, they keep playing around with him, with all the, all this, these laws and things that he's broken. And all, he should have been in prison a long time ago, but they keep playing around with him. It just shows you how they do that. Had it been anybody else, had been a black man or anybody else, he'd have been in prison a long time ago, and y'all know I'm right. And so, but they're playing games, and it looks like if he don't get back in, he's got people that are probably worse than, probably just as bad as ever worse, and they will. He's got all these different hate groups that backing him. I mean, I just heard it the other day, and I mean, he's poised to get back in. And I've already heard it from some of the Republicans, something about that this time it could just as well be a civil war in this country. I think it's going to be worse. 2023 and 2024 is going to prove to be very bad for our people. I'm just coming right out there, even the Morris, he knows it, and so does others. That is why we're reaching out to Black Lives Matter and let you know you better do something to disassemble, I'm telling you, because they're after you. It's like they're after our young black men and women still. And this here has to be said now to the young black men and women also that are out there who are going to parties and stuff and all, you know, you still got that COVID going out there. You folks need to watch this stuff. You know, this is not a joke. And they're releasing this stuff where you can catch it. So be careful. And there's nothing wrong with staying home most of the time, especially with the way things going now. We have something for you. Something that we've been talking about it. And it's called going back and turning back to the Holy Creator. And guess what? Following His commandments. The Ten Commandments, young folks and middle age, and others who've forgotten. The commandments, that's what it's all about. Maury, if you would do me the pleasure of reading the first commandment, and then once you read that first commandment, I want you to go to Deuteronomy chapter 6 and read that.
All right. The first commandment, Exodus 20, verse 1. And Elohim spake all these words, saying, I am Yahweh the Elohim, which have brought thee out of the land of Egypt, out of the house of bondage. Thou shalt have no other Elohim before me. Hallelujah. And in Deuteronomy, the sixth chapter, starting at verse
1. Read that whole thing, 6.
Now, these are the commandments, the statutes, and the judgments which Yahweh your Elohim commanded to teach you, that you might do them in the land where you go to possess it, that you might fear Yahweh your Elohim to keep all his statutes and his commandments, which I command you this day, and you and your son, and your son's son, and all the days of your life, and that your days may be prolonged. Hear, therefore, O Israel, and observe to do it, that it may be well with you, and that you may increase mightily as Yahweh Elohim of your fathers has promised you, in the land that flows with milk and honey. Hear, O Israel, Yahweh our Elohim is one Yahweh, and you shall love Yahweh your Elohim with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your might. And these words which I command you this day shall be in your heart, and you shall teach them diligently unto your children, and you shall talk of them when you sit in your house, and when you walk by the way, and when you lie down, and when you rise up. And you shall bind them as a sign upon your hand, and they shall be as frontlets between your eyes. And you shall write them upon the posts of your house and on the gates. And it shall be when Yahweh your Elohim shall have brought thee into the land which he swore to your fathers, to Abraham, Isaac, and to Jacob, to give you a great and goodly cities, which you built not, and houses full of good things, which you filled not, and walls dug, which you dug not, and vineyards and olive trees, which you planted not. When you shall have eaten to the full and be full, then beware you forget, lest you forget Yahweh, which brought you forth out of the land of Egypt from the house of bondage. You shall fear Yahweh your Elohim and serve him, and shall swear by his name. You shall not go after other deities of the deities of the people which are about you. For Yahweh Elohim is a jealous Elohim among you, lest the anger of Yahweh your Elohim be kindled against you and destroy you from off the face of the earth. You shall not tempt Yahweh your Elohim as you tempted him in Massah. You shall diligently keep the commandments of Yahweh your Elohim and his testimonies and his statutes which he has commanded you. And you shall do that which is right and good in the sight of Yahweh, that it may be well.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. I hope you heard that loud and clear, everyone. That's why I told him to read the first commandment. The Ten Commandments are no joke, people. It's what destroyed our people about five or six times before they finally went into bondage for the final time for 400 years. And boy, did we catch hell. Getting caught after coming to this country, what did they do? Hang us on trees. Made logs and put them together and everything, and burned a lot of our people on logs while they were still alive. Raping our women, amongst other things. And I don't want to get too far with what we're saying here now, but I just wanted to show you that. But that, the first commandment, and then when I told him to read Deuteronomy chapter 6 is just an add-on to that, boy, to let you know exactly what time it is.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
The first commandment.
Thou shalt not have no other Elohim before.
And the second.
Thou shalt not make unto thee any graven images.
And then the third commandment.
Thou shalt not take the name of
Yahweh. Thou shalt not take the name of thy Lord, thy God, in vain.
Mm-hmm.
For he would not hold him guiltless to take his name in vain.
That's right.
The fourth commandment.
That's remember the Sabbath day to keep it holy. Remember the Sabbath day to keep it holy. 6 days shall you labor and do all thy work, but the 7 days of the Shabbat of Yahweh the Elohim. In it thou shalt not do any work. Thou, nor thy son, nor thy daughter, nor thy manservant, nor thy maidservant, nor thy stranger, nor the cattle that's within thy gates. For in 6 days Yahweh made the heaven, the earth, the sea, and all that in them is, and he rested on the Sabbath day. Wherefore Yahweh blessed the Sabbath day and hallowed it.
Hallelujah. You see, we're doing this, and I'm going here, like to the first, second, third, and fourth, to show you just how important this is. I mean, this is serious. All of them are. But I wanted to hit those four because we keep failing to realize that, hey, nobody's keeping the first or the second or the third or the fourth. And we got to do that. There's no other way around this. We're talking about the Holy Creator's laws here, not man-made laws. We have to follow. Start at today if you haven't. And we've got something for you young folks and middle age and others. Not going to say what it is yet. But we need you. We need your attention. Black Lives Matter, all of you. We need your attention to all of this. If you're sick and tired of hearing about our people being murdered and shot down in the streets by these lunatics, and it will stop. But we have to get back right with the Holy Creator and follow his commandments. It's the only way. And you know, Black Lives Matter. I know you're saying, why do we keep picking on you? We love you and we want you saved and we want you to turn yourselves around before it's too late. And I'm going to show you something real quick because you're the fourth. You're the first one that used that word, black. We had Black Wall Street. I'm pretty sure you guys heard of them. They pretty much did the same thing you're doing. They had it going on. And they are their own schools, they own everything in Tulsa, Oklahoma. And but they fail to realize you didn't do that on your own. A lot of you think you did. You, Black Wall Street, what's that other one? From the city of Detroit. Oh, boy.
I can't remember.
It'll come back to me. But anyway, you didn't get that well on your own. They were just like you. I mean, they had made it big, you know, up there. Only schools and everything, only once. But then Yah says, oh, no. I'm not going to let this go on with this because you realize you fail to do a couple things. You fail to give him all the credit for what you've got and the way you've gotten it. And you went into the wrong place on a Sunday. The holy day is Saturday. The holy day is Saturday. It's the Sabbath day. But you went into the church on Sundays. Now you go on worshiping man and not worshiping Yah. Yah is only to be worshiped on the Sabbath day, which is Saturday, Black Lives Matter. Somebody should have told that to Black Wall Street and Black Bottom in the city of Detroit. They used to own a whole strip bars and everything and all, where they had city of Detroit. And they had these stars coming in from Las Vegas. The older woman that I can't, I'm not on it right now and everything, but Sammy Davis Jr. and his group, Sammy Davis Jr., Rat Pack and all of them, Dean Martin and Frank Sinatra and others. They came into town just to perform on a Saturday. But they failed to realize what I just said. You know, they thought that they did it on their own. They didn't know that the Holy Creator is the one that gives you that power to be able to do the things you do. and everything, and you did not worship him. They did not go. They did not worship him on the right day, which is a Saturday, the Sabbath day. Instead, they went into the man's church, not Yah's sanctuary, but the church on a Sunday, and that is the wrong day of the week. And because of that, they lost everything they had. And that's the same thing that's going to happen to you, Black Wall Street. I mean, Black Lives Matter. I'm just letting you know now. Hey, I'm giving you a heads up on that. So anyway, we're going to go to, worship our Father a little bit by playing some nice music, spiritual music for him. And so listen up, and we'll be right back.
Holy, holy, holy. what brought you to this place? The tears, the pain, the sorrow. But in all you go through, remember I is there for you. There's nothing so hard that he
thank you.
Hallelujah. Oh yeah, this here is for all of the elders and the people who have been watching and been calling in trying to find out when the next one was. Well, we haven't forgotten you at all. We haven't forgotten you at all, but I'm going to start off, I'm going to play this song by Gladys Knight.
Hey, you know, everybody's talking about the good old days, right? Everybody, the good old days, the good old days. Well, let's talk about the good old days. Come to think of it, as bad as we think they are, these will become the good old days for our children.
Good boy.
Try to remember. And if you remember, then follow. Oh, why does it seem that the past is always better? We look back and we think the winters were warmer, the grass was greener, the skies were bluer, and smiles were bright. Can it be that it was all so simple then? Or has time rewritten every line? And if we had the chance to do it all again, tell me, would we? Could we? Memories like the colors of my mind. Misty watercolor memories of the way we were. Scattered pictures of the smiles we left behind. Smiles we gave to one another for the way we were. Oh, can it be that it was all so simple then? Oh, has time rewritten every line? And if we had the chance to do it all again, tell me, would we? What's too painful to remember? We simply choose to forget. So, the laughter we will remember. Remember the way we were.
Hallelujah. Praise the mighty one of Israel. All right. Okay, folks. Yes, we'll be turning off now. We'll see you next week. If y'all allows, and I'm sure he will. But anyway, yeah. So it's good to be back. We'll see you again, folks. And remember, Yah loves you, and so do we.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Shalom, shalom.
Shalom, shalom.